Alright, what's up guys? Today I'm going to be switching out my 2005 Dove Airx seats and putting in some newer 2002 Dove Airx seats with no tears. As far as overall comfort, that's the only reason why I'm kind of switching back. The 05s look really nice, but the 02s are just overall more comfortable, and I do spend a lot of time driving as far as like just general trips or like picking up parts and stuff like that, and so comfort is very key for me. So yeah, let's get started. So for this job, you're only gonna really need your 14 millimeter and possibly a flathead screwdriver. First off, kind of like a rule of thumb, is that you're gonna go ahead and want to clean out your car. Oh well, gonna be using this for a little bit. Star smog, thank you very much. State of California. So we're gonna go ahead and just toss that there. Toss that there. You're gonna see a 14 millimeter right there. And then over here, I don't know if you can see it or not, but there is another a little cover right there that you're gonna go ahead and pop off. Let's see if you can see that. Okay. Be one 14 millimeter bolt. Save these and don't misplace them. They don't need to go in any particular order. Less of a headache when you don't have to like scrounge around and like look around and shit. There's the other one out. Okay. Well, now we can move to the front. Oh, okay. I'm gonna grab this and put the seat all the way back as far as possible. All right, let's get started. And then to the other side. All right, so now the seat is completely off. Before you go off and fucking up shit and start yanking things out, there is a clip right here that you need to undo, and then you can go ahead and pull the seat out. Cause if not, you're gonna just like bust some shit. And of course, you always have to have your leaf because cars can be a fucking headache sometimes. So I'm gonna go ahead and try to show you how to do this. So these have a special like release button. In case you guys are doing this for the first time, you push this downwards. This is why I got the flathead to begin with, because sometimes these things can be pretty stubborn, but in this case, it's actually not that bad. I just had it though. And this is gonna slide. Yeah. And that should be it. That should be. That's how you release that. Alright, so now we can go ahead and pull this thing out. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. However, way you can get it out, just get it out. So I don't gotta clean out too much on this end, because obviously, for obvious reasons. I might have to take some stuff out from the back though. So this one towards the center console, this one towards the door. On to the other side. Oh, damn. That is nice. I know a place where we can head up there, sail on the sunset to the sky. Wait. All right, seats are all swapped out. Yeah. Yeah. I just realized that I had to put back my bypass valve and give my buddy back his wall valve. He needed my stock one for smog, so we're gonna go ahead and do that real quick, and I'll show you how. First, you open up this dirty ass. So this is like the stockest you're ever gonna see this car. Well, aside from that, but I mean, this is what we're gonna be changing out. It's a trusty 12 millimeter. It helps if you have like a ratchet wrench, that's pretty cool. Needle nose pliers for this ring of death right here. And a 10 millimeter, as well as another 12, and your trusty old ratchet. So, real quick, these bolts right here that hold the block valve in place are the 12 millimeters that you'll be needing. You'll need the extension to grab this one right here on this side, and you'll need the ratchet wrench that comes in handy to come in to get this one right here, because the extension just won't fit. There's not enough space right there. So this part right here, I don't have hooked up onto the intercooler. Those are usually the 10 millimeters that you'll have to unbolt. If you can see, there's a threading right there. So I just popped this guy off. So here's the gasket. That's what that looks like. And then there's this thing. All right, so the block off plate, this is what it looks like. I usually like to shimmy this thing. You really don't need like the ring of death, but I mean it helps. Oh, did I break? Fuck. Okay, I don't know if you can see that, but here's what I was talking about. So you have the gasket right there with the thread, over the thread of the bolt, and the bolt partially started in, as well as on the other side. So when you tighten them down, they go in evenly, and you don't have to really worry about it. All right, everything put together, and we are ready to go. We'll stay right here. What's that? That looks a little too red to be fucking stock. Oh, man. I'd get popped for sure. Look, quick review of these seats. They are freaking amazing. I'm so surprised that like I even thought about changing to the other ones. I gotta make sure I get like a proper mount for this car. The other ones looked good. They looked a lot better, but I mean, in the end, like it just really wasn't like comfortable. Not to me, anyways. I focus more on comfort than anything because at the end of the day, you gotta do it. But feels good to you. Alright guys, well we're on our way to Subaru right now. Gonna go ahead and see what's going on. I ordered an STI flywheel and pressure plate, and my throwout bearing just didn't go in there with the monolock. So I think there's a missing piece in there. So I'll just show it to me. Okay, so this is what I was talking about. So this part right here. I feel like there's a missing piece in between that right there that would be considered like a retainer ring or something like that, but I'm gonna find out. So we're at Subaru right now, and we're gonna talk to you guys soon. Alright guys, got some bad news. I went to Subaru, the clutch cover is in fact garbage. Looks like I'm gonna have to just order a new clutch cover. So the flywheel is fine, just the clutch cover. Got the throwout bearing, got the monolock. That's the only thing, missing piece of the puzzle that's keeping me from putting everything together. So I'm gonna go ahead and order that tonight, hopefully, and then see how it goes from there.